This quarter, we've been studying Russia, Ukraine, Belarus, Moldova, Armenia, Afghanistan, and a lot of other stands that I can't say. And so the children have been learning about how God has been reaching people in these places, and they have been learning how people live in these places and stories of children that they can relate to, and how these children have been learning about God and how God has touched them in such a special way. And this quarter, we have been raising a special offering to go to our mission projects that are going to these places to build churches in Belarus. Let's see, we're going to be constructing churches in schools in Ukraine, and Zaokski Adventist School in Russia, and different projects that our class is collecting money for. So this whole quarter, they've been working hard, and we'll let you know how much we collected at the end. But that's why today they are representing the countries of Afghanistan, Russia, Moldova, Ukraine, and all of this region that we have been studying. So also in the lessons that they have been studying, they have been reading how God has always fought our battles. And we don't have to fight them on our own. We are not alone. If you have God on your side, he will fight your battles for you. And all of their Bible stories were centered around that theme. So the song that the children are going to be singing right now is called Armor of God. Mission story for today, and our mission story is called Teach Us to Pray. And this story is about a teacher named Natalia, and she taught in high school. She taught ninth graders, and she always liked to teach these children how to pray. And she would put them in a circle, and she would have them share their, you know, prayer requests or their worries, and they would pray. And one day, she asked a young girl named Victoria if she could pray. Victoria was 15 years old, and her eyes went real huge, and her mouth dropped, and she was terrified because she didn't know how to pray. So she told her teacher, "You want me to pray?" And the teacher said, "Yeah." And she said, "But I don't know how to pray. What am I supposed to say?" So the teacher told her, "Well, you can begin like this. You can say, 'Dear God.'" "So that's how I should start?" Victoria said. "Yes, and then you can talk to him and tell him whatever you want to tell him." So Victoria started to pray, and she asked God to bless them and to help them be a light to others, because they had just read a story on how God wants us to be a light to others and how God raises the sun every day and shines on the good people and the bad. And that story also said that Jesus shines his love on all of us the same way. So Victoria prayed for that, for God to help them to be a light to others. Victoria was not the only child who was scared to pray aloud. Out of everybody in the classroom, only 4 children came from Christian families. The others had never been to church, or they didn't know too much about God, so they were kind of scared of praying because they didn't know how. The teacher wanted them to experience the power of prayer. So after praying the first time, Victoria was not scared anymore to pray. She liked it. But her best friend, Ruslan, she refused to pray. She was just terrified. She said, "I was just so scared to pray," Ruslan said. "I can't pray in front of everybody. What if I mess up, or what if I say the wrong things and people laugh at me?" But one day, Victoria got really sick. And at first they just thought that she had an ear infection or a cold, and that she would be okay. But the days kept passing by and her ear infection got worse and worse. She ended up in the hospital, and it turns out that she had a terrible infection which could actually cause her to lose her hearing permanently. And it was so severe that they were gonna have to do a surgery. So Victoria didn't come to school for a whole month. And during this time, her best friend, Ruslan, was beginning to worry. One day, the teacher came in and told them, "You know, today I want us to pray specially for Victoria, because Victoria is going to be having surgery today. And we need to pray that everything goes well, because it is very risky and she may lose her hearing." And so that morning, the teacher asked, "Who wants to pray?" And Ruslan all of a sudden blurted out, "I do." And all of a sudden she realized what she had said. She said, "Oh my goodness, I just said I wanted to pray and I don't know how to pray. I've never prayed." But she decided she was going to do it anyway because she was so worried about her best friend, Victoria. And so she wasn't so sure what to say, but she closed her eyes and she started. And she said, "Dear Jesus, bless Victoria's operation and help her not to lose her hearing. Heal her and help her to return to our class. Amen." That evening, they found out the operation was a success. And a few weeks later, Victoria was able to come back to school. God hears all of our prayers, especially the prayers of children who are scared. That's what the teacher, Natalia, says. We shouldn't be afraid to open our hearts to God. We can pray anywhere, anytime, and God will answer in ways that we cannot even begin to imagine. This quarter's 13th Sabbath offering is going to help teacher Natalia's school construct its own school building in Buka, Ukraine. Currently, their school is borrowing classrooms from the university, and so our offerings this 13th Sabbath is going to go to help them build their own schools and also to help build a school in Zalksky Christian School in Russia. And that was our mission story. Back to the theme that God fights our battles and answers our prayers, the children at this time are going to be singing the Lord's Army.